I'm Hannah Taylor. The statistics are shocking. 8 in 10 students experience some sort of harassment during their school years. Title IX exists to lower that number. Title IX is a law passed in the 70s to enforce gender equality for boys and girls in all educational programs that receive federal funding. Recently, Hanover has furthered its efforts to spread awareness of this law around campus. The Interfraternal Council has started a campaign to inform each Greek house on the particulars of Title IX to make sure that students know their rights. Last Monday, they spoke at the Chi Omega House.
So why are we presenting this? Why are we talking about sexual misconduct? Greek life, you're generally the leaders on campus, and you have the potential to make our campus safer through your actions through the weekends and whatnot. We believe the values of fraternity stories are at odds with sexual misconduct, and we want to help create a safer and healthier campus environment.
With us today, we have Hanover's Title IX resident expert, Director of Student Housing, Casey Heckler. Welcome, Casey. Thanks for being here today.
Thanks for having me.
Casey is an advocate for furthering students' awareness of Title IX and sexual safety on campus. Casey, Title IX has been around since the 70s, so why is this law so relevant all of a sudden?
Well, recently, actually in April of 2011, the Office of Civil Rights issued what they call a Dear Colleague letter. And that was to all levels of higher education and actually all education institutions, okay, telling us this is what we need to be doing in regards to sexual misconduct, sexual assault, violence against women, and ways that we need to protect our students. So what happened, that letter was incredibly vague, as the Department of Education sometimes tends to be. It says you need to do these things, but they didn't tell us specifically how to go about doing that.
Okay.
In January of 2013, there was a letter and a task force issued by the White House, and this task force got together and established some guidelines and cleared up what we should really be doing. So in April of last year, they issued a FAQ and some statements about what we should be doing as institutions of higher education to protect our students and to educate our community.
Okay, great. Like we said earlier, 8 in 10 students experience some sort of harassment during their school years.
Mm-hmm.
That's a pretty big percentage. What exactly, or more specifically, is Hanover doing to combat and lower those numbers?
Right. As many of you know from the emails you've been receiving this year from Workplace Answers, we have enlisted the help of that company. And you have two components that you have to do. It is educating you on harassment in the workplace in case you are a student who is an employee of the college. And then there's also information about sexual misconduct, Title IX violations, and ways to get resources. So that went to all faculty, staff, and students. So our entire campus community received that. Our first year students did something a little different this year in August experience called Think About It, which talked about alcohol, drugs, and then sexual misconduct as well.
Mm-hmm.
So they were asked to do that online program, and then they met within their group as well and had discussions about that, kind of some informal, real-life discussions. So we've done that, and then IFC and Panhellenic are going around doing their talks. This is just the tip of the iceberg, though. We need to be having more conversations, mm-hmm, and those things will start
Definitely.
To unfold in the fall.
And I was there when they spoke in the Chi Omega House, and the,
mm-hmm,
new members really found it very resourceful. They said they really enjoyed it.
Good.
So are students aware of the resources on campus if they ever do find themselves victims of harassment?
I want to say yes, but I'm not certain that that's true. I am the Title IX coordinator, which means that I am responsible for the educational component, but I'm also the person that when a student comes and says, I've been a victim of sexual misconduct, or I've been discriminated against based on my gender, I'm the one who can kind of help start that process.
Okay.
Shelley Prio Cannon over in Human Resources is the Title IX deputy. So she helps with situations where we're looking at faculty or staff. So if a student is feeling harassed by a faculty or staff member or a vendor, Shelley kind of helps guide that, and she and I work closely together, and then I deal with mainly student-on-student complaints.
Okay.
So we talk about, that information is made available. There's pamphlets around campus. There are some other resources. Counseling services are confidential resources, so if a student doesn't want to move forward with any action within the college yet, they can talk to those, to the counselors and the chaplain as well, and
okay,
receive support and counseling through that process without having to take any steps to file a formal complaint.
Okay, great. Yeah. And what do you suggest for students who would like to be more proactive with this law? This is obviously too big for one group alone to take on.
I think that we will be working on some new student groups for the fall, some student outreach, some peer education, because we find that does work really well. Matt Digg has done a great job with IFC in developing that program, but we are kind of working behind the scenes right now to open that up so that more people can help get involved in educating our campus.
Okay, great. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for being here today, Casey. Hopefully those watching feel more informed on all that implies it with a Title IX. For those of you who would like to learn more information about Title IX, you can visit www.title9.info. I'm Hannah Taylor. Thanks for watching.